Hi everyone, in today's video I'm going to show you how to share your phone screen using Streamlabs Mobile and IRLHosting.com in just three easy steps. Step 1, start an IRL broadcast with Streamlabs Mobile. Step 2, relay the broadcast through IRL Hosting. Step 3, into a media source in OBS. Done. There's a couple reasons why you'd want to share your phone screen. Firstly, it could be to show how awesome you are at Pokemon Go. Share your latest non-spicy photos with your viewers, watch your latest YouTube video with them and more. If you've seen my other videos on IRL live streaming, you might already have an idea of where I'm going with all of this. Basically, the iOS version of Streamlabs can broadcast your phone screen directly to a streaming platform like Twitch, YouTube, or a custom RTMP. For step 1, download and install Streamlabs from the App Store if you don't already have it. Tap on the Go Live button, select a platform, and connect another account. Scroll to the very bottom where you'll find the option to set up a custom RTMP. We'll come back to this in a sec. IRL Hosting offers what they call a relay endpoint for RTMP, which is currently $9.99 USD a month. And if you're wondering, this is an unsponsored video and I paid for this plan with my own money. For step 2, go to their website to get started now. Choose a billing cycle, operating system, RTMP endpoint, and location. I'm in New Zealand, so I've gone with Sydney, Australia. The rest is pretty self-explanatory. Review, checkout, and fill in your payment details. After you've completed your order and confirmed your email address, you'll be sent the info you need to log into your account or client area. And after you're signed in, you'll see your active products and services in this middle area. According to their website, it says you'll have access in less than 5 minutes. If they mean the service, for me, it took almost 3 hours before I could use it. Their support team was pretty quick to get in touch with me and even got it working earlier than expected. So that was cool. When the status changes from pending to active, you're pretty much good to go. Click to open the service details where you'll find these three things: your RTMP URL, OBS ingest, and NOALBS stats URL. The first one is for your IRL live streaming app. The second for the media source in OBS. And the third one is for NOALBS to handle auto scene switching and bitrate info on the new service, which I don't think you need because I'm sure it'll interfere with the Cam 1 scene we set up in OBS. Back to step 1, copy the RTMP URL and send it to your phone in whatever secure way works for you. In Streamlabs, and for your custom RTMP, give it a name like ScreenShare. URL is the RTMP URL from irlhosting.com, and StreamKey is the last part of the RTMP URL from the previous step. Cut and paste it from the StreamKey, then save. And finally, for step 3, open OBS and add a media source to any scene. You can change it later. Give it a name like Source Screen Share. Uncheck local file and restart playback. Then paste the OBS ingest URL from irlhosting.com into the input field. Leave all the other fields as is. No other changes. Then click on OK to save. In Streamlabs, tap on the Go Live button. When asked, do you want to share your screen or camera, choose Screen Share. For the next step, where do you want to broadcast to? Select Screen Share from the list. Then Next. Give it a stream title and description like My First Screen Share. Save. Then the green Go Live button. An iPhone dialog box will ask if you'd like to broadcast with Streamlabs. Tap Start Broadcast to start sharing your phone screen. Quickly navigate to whatever app you'd like to show your viewers, and then you're good to go. To end the screen share, tap on the red button in the top left corner of your iPhone screen, where it'll ask if you'd like to stop broadcasting screen with Streamlabs. So here's the final version of what you could do with all this. I've installed the Source Clone plugin into this instance of OBS, restarted OBS for the changes to take effect, then created a new scene called Scene Screen Share, where I've got the new media source and cloned source of the Cam 1 scene with the video buffer set to 1/4 so it's easier on my computer's resources. Moved it to the bottom left and placed the screen share source behind it. In order to navigate to the scene, I can use a chat command like !screenshare. If you'd like to know how to set up custom chat commands, check out this fully in-depth video on StreamBot right over here.